وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال. وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد. سورة الفجر. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. والفجر وليال عشر والشفع والوتر والليل إذا يسر هل في ذلك قسم لذي حجر ألم تر كيف فعل ربك بعاد إرم ذات العماد التي لم يخلق مثلها في البلاد وثمود الذين جابوا الصخر بالواد وفرعون ذي الأوتاد الذين طغوا في البلاد فأكثروا فيها الفساد فصب عليهم ربك سوط عذاب إن ربك لبالمرصاد فأما الإنسان إذا ما ابتلاه ربه فأكرمه ونعمه فيقول ربي أكرمن وأما إذا ما ابتلاه فقدر عليه رزقه فيقول ربي أهانن كلا بل لا تكرمون اليتيم ولا تحاضون على طعام المسكين وتأكلون التراث أكلا لما وتحبون المال حبا جما كلا إذا دكت الأرض دكا دكا وجاء ربك والملك صفا صفا وجيء يومئذ بجهنم يومئذ يتذكر الإنسان وأنى له الذكرى يقول يا ليتني قدمت لحياتي فيومئذ لا يعذب عذابه أحد ولا يوثق وثاقه أحد يا أيتها النفس المطمئنة ارجعي إلى ربك راضية مرضية فادخلي في عبادي وادخلي جنتي. سورة الفجر. سورة الفجر is a Meccan surah based on the view of the Jumhur Ahl al-Ilm, the overwhelming majority of scholars. They hold the opinion that Surah Al-Fajr is a Meccan surah. It came down before the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam migrated to Medina. And there is a view which is strange, qawlun which is shadh, a strange opinion which says that it is annaha madaniyah, that it came down after the Messenger migrated to Medina. But that view is what? Shad. Shad means what? Strange. It is opposing the view of the overwhelming majority of scholars. Then Surah Al-Fajr is what? It's a Meccan surah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, wal fajri, by the fajr. The waw in wal fajr is called waw al qasam. The waw in wal fajr, it's called the waw al qasam. What does it mean? It means Allah is making a oath. He's swearing by something, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in the Arabic language, there are three letters that are used for an oath. In the Arabic language, there are three letters. There are three letters that are used for the oath. The first one is the waw, and the second one is the ba, and the third one is the ta. The first one is waw. The first one is the waw. Allah said in the Quran, قَالُوا وَاللَّهِ رَبِّنَا مَا كُنَّا مُشْرِكِينَ. قَالُوا, they said, وَاللَّهِ, by our Lord, مَا كُنَّا مُشْرِكِينَ, we were never pagans and polytheists. The second one is ba. Allah says, قَالُوا تَقَاسَمُوا بِاللَّهِ, ba. And the third one is ta. وَتَاللَّهِ وَتَاللَّهِ لَأَكِيدَنَّ أَصْنَامَكُمْ بَعْدَ أَن تُوَلُّوا مُدِبِرِينَ. وَتَاللَّهِ لَأَكِيدَنَّ أَصْنَامَكُمْ. Wow, ba, and ta. Wallahi, billahi, and tallahi, you say. But they are different. All three of them are not the same. Even that though they all show that the person is making an oath, but they are all differently used. The wow is used for an ism zahir, an apparent noun. The waw, it is used for an apparent noun, ism zahir, or what you would say in English grammar, proper noun. And it's also used for a pronoun, a dhamir. So it's only used for an ism zahir, sorry. The waw is only used for an ism zahir, and it's not used for a pronoun. And you can never mention with it the verb uqsimu. You can never mention that verb with it. So what is the waw used for? It's used for a apparent noun. Okay? And you cannot mention the verb uqsimu with it. The second one is the ba. The ba enters the ism zahir, the apparent noun, and it also enters the pronoun, the dhamair in the Arabic language. And you mention uqsimu with it. For example, you say uqsimu billahi. And you can also say uqsimu bihi. Bihi is a pronoun. So it went to in what? A proper noun, which is uqsimu billahi. That's a proper noun. And it also enters into a pronoun, which is uqsimu bi, and you also have to mention the verb uqsimu with it. The third one is the ta, and the ta only enters lafdhul jalala. It only enters the term Allah. It cannot be used for anything else. So you can't even say tarrahman. Rahman, is it not from the names of Allah? It is, but the ta can't be used for it. It is only used for the name Allah. So you can only use it for what? Tallahi, only for Allah. And you cannot mention with it the verb uqsimu. You cannot mention with it. So which of the three was used here? The waw was used. Wal fajri. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he swears by the fajr. What does it mean, wal fajri, the fajr that Allah is swearing by? According to the scholars of tafsir, they have three opinions, three views of what is meant by al-fajr here. How many views? There are three views. The first one is the dawn. It is the dawn. Allah is swearing by the dawn. That view is attributed to Ikrimah from the Mufassirin. It's also attributed to Abdullah ibn Abbas. It is also attributed to Mujahid ibn Jabrin. And it's also attributed to Suddi. They are the ones who said it means the dawn. So some of the translation in English, you'll see it says by the dawn. That's one view. The second view is it means an-nahar, the day. The whole entire day is referred to al-fajr. This view is attributed to Abdullah ibn Abbas alone, even though it is min tariqi Abi Nasrin, from the chain of Abi Nasrin. وَفِيهِ غَرَابَ. It's a bit strange, because the Arabs don't generally use the word fajr for the whole day. But maybe Ibn Abbas said it min bab al-muqabala, because what is after wal-fajr? وَلَيَالٍ عَشْرٍ. Because night was mentioned, he mentioned day here. Min bab al-muqabala. The night was mentioned in the next verse, so here the day will be mentioned. The third view is, it means the Salatul Fajr. It means Salatul Fajr. And that view is also attributed to Abdullah ibn Abbas himself. And Shaykhuna, Shaykh Salih ibn Abdullah ibn Hamid al-Usaymi, he said it makes more sense to attribute it to which one? The third one. Because the word Al-Fajr in the Sharia, what is it used as? If somebody just say to you, I came from Fajr, what would you understand it as? The particular prayer, right? So the Shaykh said it's better to restrict it to the shar'i term that is used for it. Allah says, وَالْفَجْرِ, by the dawn I swear, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he's saying. وَلَيَالٍ عَشْرٍ, and by 10 nights. And I also swear, Allah is saying, by the what? By the 10 nights. What is meant by the 10 nights here? And what is intended by it? There are three views regarding what is meant by وَلَيَالٍ عَشْرٍ, the 10 nights. The first view is the 10 here that is meant is الْأُوَلُ مِنْ ذِي الْحِجَّةِ, the first 10 of ذِي الْحِجَّةِ, the first 10 of ذِي الْحِجَّةِ. الْأُوَلُ مِنْ ذِي الْحِجَّةِ, the first 10 of what? ذِي الْحِجَّةِ. That's one view. And Ibn Jarir al-Tabari in his tafsir, he brought a consensus that is what is meant by it. Again, the first view is the first 10 of ذِي الْحِجَّةِ. And Ibn Jarir al-Tabari naqal al-ijma', he transmitted a consensus, and he said that's a consensus, but there is no consensus, because the second group, they also transmitted a consensus, which is the 10 last of Ramadan, the last 10 of Ramadan. And Tibrizi, the Imam al-Tibrizi, he transmitted the ijma' that is meant by those 10. Are we all together? And the third view is, the third view is, it is meant by the first 10 of the month of Muharram. And the strongest of those three, before I strengthen one over the other, or I favor one over the other, the overwhelming majority of scholars are of the opinion that وَلَيَالٍ عَشْرٍ is meant the 10 of Dhul Hijjah. But the one that seems strongest is, it does not mean the 10 of Dhul Hijjah, rather it means the 10 nights of Ramadan. Why? And why did we strengthen this over the other? Because the scholars, they say, تَرْجِيحٌ بِغَيْرِ مُرَجَّحٍ يُسَمَّ التَّحَكُمْ. We can't strengthen one opinion over the other without a valid reason, or else we will be using what is known in ilm al-munadara as at-tahakkum, dictatorship. We're forcing our view there. The reason is because the virtue of the first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah is not the nights, it's the days. And the virtues of the last 10 nights of Ramadan is what? It's nights, not the day. وَلِذَلِكَ, the scholars, they reconciled by saying the first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah, the first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah is better than the last 10 days of Ramadan. But the last 10 nights of Ramadan is better than the first 10 nights of Dhul Hijjah. Does that make sense? ولذلك the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said in a hadith, الإمام البخاري narrated من حديث ابن عباس رضي الله تعالى عنهما, that the Messenger said, ما العمل في أيام العشر أفضل من العمل في هذه. ما العمل, any righteous deeds that a person does is not as good as the 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. The Prophet didn't say nights. What did he say? He said days, sallallahu alayhi wasallam. The companions then they said, walal jihad, even jihad, O Messenger of Allah. The Messenger said, walal jihad, even jihad. Illa rajulun kharaja yukhatiru bi nafsi wa mali falam yarji' bi shay'in. Even the one who goes to the battlefield and he fights, the one who does righteous deeds in these 10 days of Dhul Hijjah is better. Except a person who loses his wealth and his money, and in another narration, his family, and he doesn't come back with anything. So the last 10 nights of Ramadan is better than the first 10 nights of Dhul Hijjah. But the first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah is better than the last 10 days of Ramadan. What did Allah say here? Did Allah say, وَلَيَالٍ عَشْرٍ? Or what did he say? وَأَيَّامِ عَشْرٍ. Allah تبارك وتعالى said, وَلَيَالٍ. So is it nights here that's been spoken about, or is it day? So since it's nights, it goes to which one? It goes to the last 10 days of Ramadan. Even that though, this opposes the view of the Jumhur. وَلَيَالٍ عَشْرٍ. Allah, he swears by subhanahu wa ta'ala, the last 10 days of Ramadan. The last 10 nights of Ramadan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he swears by it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he also swears by وَالشَّفْعِ وَالْوَتْرِ. The word al-watri, there's two qira'ah, two recitation. The first one is al-watri, and the second one is al-witri. Both are two recitations that are read. Al-watri and al-witri. Al-watri and al-witri. What is meant by wa-shaf'i wal-watr? Ama wa-shaf'i wal-witr. What is meant by it? The word al-shaf'u, it means even. Wal-watri, it means odd. Allah is swearing by the odd and the even. But what does it mean, the odd, and what does it mean, the even, that Allah is swearing by subhanahu wa ta'ala? Because the waw here is waw al-atf. The waw in wal-shaf'i wal-watr is connected to the qasam that Allah made before. And also by the odd and the even. What is the odd and what is the even? What is the even and the odd? The scholars, they have three opinions. There are three opinions what is meant by the odd and even. Rather, the views, they reached 20 different views. Al-Fakhruddin al-Razi transmitted it, and also Ibn al-Jawzi in his Zadul Masir, they both transmitted it. 20 views. But we're going to choose three prominent ones, the three strongest ones. The first one is the shaf'a is meant by Yawmun Nahr, the day of the slaughter. And the witr is meant by Yawmu Arafah, the day of Arafah. That's one view. And this view is attributed to five great scholars. The first one is Ibn Abbas. The second one is Ikrimah. The third one is Sufyan al-Thawri. The fourth is Qatada. And the fifth is Dhahak. The second opinion is Al-Shaf'u, it means Al-Khalq, the creation. Because the creation, they come in even, two by two. Men and women. Jannah and Nar, because the Jannah is a creation, right? So everything, Allah brought it in pairs. And the witr is what? Allah. Because the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, what did he say? Inna Allah witrun yuhibbu al-witra. Allah is odd and he loves, because Allah is one, right? Is one not odd? One is odd. This view is attributed to Ibn Abbas and Mujahid and Ibn Juraij. The third opinion is, it's referring to as-salat al-maktuba, the prayers that we pray. Some prayers are what? Al-shaf'u, and some of them are what? Al-witru. Some prayers we pray two, and some of the salah is what? Al-witr, one. You just pray one witr. Those are the three views. Ibn Jarir, when he brought all of those views, he said, وَالصَّوَابُ مِنَ الْقَوْلِ أَن يُقَالَ. The strongest opinion and what we should say is, إِنَّ اللَّهَ تَعَالَى ذَكَى إِنَّ اللَّهَ تَعَالَى ذِكُ أَقْسَمَ بِالشَّفْعِ وَالْوِتْرِ وَلَمْ يُخَصِّصْ نَوْعًا مِنَ الشَّفْعِ وَلَا مِنَ الْوِتْرِ دُونَ نَوْعٍ بِخَبَرٍ وَلَا عَقْلٍ وَكُلُّ شَفْعٍ وَوِتْرٍ فَهُوَ مِمَّا أَقْسَمَ بِهِ مِمَّا قَالَ أَهْلُ التَّأْوِيلِ أَنَّهُ دَاخِلٌ فِي قَسَمِهِ هَذَا لِعُمُومِ قَسَمِهِ بِذَلِكَ. He said, because Allah did not restrict it. Allah left it unrestricted. Allah said, odd and even. So all of the mufassirin, what they mentioned, all of them fall under it. Because Allah left it what? General. And the reason why Allah left it general is so all of that can enter it. Allah left it subhanahu wa ta'ala what? He left it unrestricted. And so all of that can fall under. وَالشَّفْعِ وَالْوَتْرِ. And by the even number and the odd number, Allah swears by subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَاللَّيْلِ. And by the night, Allah swears when it passes. إِذَا يَسْرِ. Allah is swearing by the night, subhanahu wa ta'ala. When is he swearing by it? إِذَا ذَهَبَ وَصَارِ. When the night passes, Allah is swearing by it, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then Allah, tabarak wa ta'ala, he says, هَلْ فِي ذَلِكَ قَسَمٌ لِذِي حُجْرٍ. Is it not, Allah is saying, is there not in all of that oath, all of that qasam Allah made, is there not in all of that oath that Allah made, is it not in it لِذِي حُجْرٍ, for a person of aql, a person of perception, a person of intellect, is it not enough for them to see what Allah saw by? Allah is saying, in all of that which I saw by, is it not sufficient for one of perception, a person who has aql, لصاحب عقل, is there not in it for that person enough? Is it not sufficient for them? What it means here is a rhetorical question. Allah is not asking you a direct question. What it means in the question is that all of those things that Allah saw by are great things, and in them are enough for a person to ponder and understand the greatness of Allah's commandments and the greatness of Allah's prohibition, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Here we need to understand, brothers. When you swear by something, if I say to you, wallahi, you're waiting for a what? You're waiting for a jawabul qasam. The response to that what? The oath. So you're going to say to me, wallahi, wallahi what? Allah swore by all of that. The question here is, what is that oath towards? What is the answer of that oath? The jawabul qasam. So Allah swore by the wal fajri, wa layalin ashri, wa shaf'i wal wat. All of that Allah saw by it. What is the jawabul qasam? The scholars, they said the jawabul qasam is mahduf, it's hidden. And how would we know what it is? Because the context of what Allah is going to speak about allows us to know what it is. And what is it? It is لَتُجَازُنَّ بِأَعْمَالِكُمْ. You will all be accounted for your actions the day of judgment. When Allah says, وَالْفَجْرِ, I swear by the dawn, you will be accounted for your actions. وَالشَّفْعِ وَاللَّيْلِ وَالْفَجْرِ وَلَيَالٍ عَشْرٍ, you will be accounted for your actions. وَالشَّفْعِ وَالْوَتْرِ, you will be accounted for your actions and what you do. All of that which Allah is swearing by, the answer to it is, wallahi, you will be accounted the day of judgment for the things that you do. Brothers, we believe Allah Azza wa Jalla, without him having to make an oath, what would you think if Allah makes an oath? The matter becomes great, brothers, right? It becomes great. we would have taken it from Allah Azza wa Jalla without even having to make an oath. But he swore by all of that for us to show us how great it is and how big it is. His commandments, the things he commanded you and the things that he prohibited you from. And then Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, he then says, أَلَمْ تَرَ كَيْفَ فَعَلَ رَبُّكَ بِعَادٍ. Have you not considered? Have you not seen? The word أَلَمْ تَرَك, the scholars they said, it means أَلَمْ تَنْظُرْ يَا مُحَمَّدٍ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. Muhammad, did you not look at بِعَيْنِ قَلْبِكَ, with the eyes of your heart? Meaning, did you not deeply observe and think and contemplate over كَيْفَ فَعَلَ رَبُّكَ بِعَادٍ, how Allah dealt, how Allah dealt with the people of Ad. أَلَمْ تَرَ مُحَمَّدْ. Have you not looked at sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Have you not looked at, have you not pondered over and contemplated over كَيْفَ فَعَلَ رَبُّكَ, the way that your Lord dealt with what? بِعَاد, the people of Ad. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he destroyed the people of Ad. As Allah said in Surah Al-Qamar, كَذَّبَتْ عَادٌ فَكَيْفَ كَانَ عَذَابِي وَنُذُرُ إِنَّا أَرْسَلْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ رِيحًا صَرْصَرًا فِي يَوْمِ نَحْسٍ مُسْتَمِرٍ تَنْزِعُ النَّاسَ كَأَنَّهُمْ أَعْجَازُ نَخْلٍ مُنْقَعِرٍ. Allah, he sent to them a wind that destroyed them, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah told us, subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he sent the wind to them, they became like palm trees. They became like what? Palm trees. Allah destroyed them, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And till today, Allah's sunnah did not change in how he dealt with people who went against him. And we'll speak about that, inshallah ta'ala, how sins take away the blessing. Allah said, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, have you not thought, have you not contemplated, have you not pondered over what your Lord and the way he dealt with the people of Ad? إرام ذات العباد. إرام, what does it mean? There are five views. What is meant by إرام? The first view is إرام was a nation from the previous nations that existed. They are a أمّة من الأمم, a nation from the previous nations. This is attributed to Qatada. Qatada is the one who said this. The second one is that the word, the term Irama, it means al-qadima, old, ancient. That view is attributed to Mujahid, but that can't be correct, because if it meant qadima, then grammatically it would have been makhfud bitanween. It wouldn't have been Irama, it would have been Iramin. That's what it would have been. So that view of Mujahid is incorrect. The third one is Irama was a balad, a village from the villages of the people of Ad. This is a view attributed to Muhammad ibn Ka'ab al-Quradi. The fourth view is Iram is the great-great-grandfather of the people of Ad, is where they come from. It's the people of Ad where they come from. This view is also attributed to Qatada. Last but not least, the fifth view is Irama actually means those who were destroyed. Those who were destroyed, and this is attributed to two great scholars, Abdullah ibn Abbas and Dhahak ibn Muzahim. Irama, will take the view that Irama is the great grandfathers of the people of Ad. Allah says, إِرَمَ ذَاتُ الْعِبَادِ. إِرَمَ ذَاتِ الْعِبَادِ. إِرَمَ, the people of إِرَمَ, they were ذَاتِ الْعِبَادِ. They were a people who had lofty pillar. What does it mean, ذَاتُ الْعِبَادِ? ذَاتُ الْعِبَادِ means they were a people who were excessively big. The people of Ad, they were very big people. Very strong and very tall people they were. But when you look at the books of tafsir, you find exaggeration when it comes to the people of Ad. You come across a story of a man by the name of Awj ibn Anaq. Some scholars, they said that he was 3,000 dirah. How many? 3,000 dirah. About 300,000 dirah. One of the two, I don't remember. And they said that he was so tall, he would take the fish from the ocean and he would warm it up on the sun. Haqiqah, they mentioned this. In the books of tafsir and the books of history, they mention it. And Ibn Kathir and Al-Qadi Abi Bakr Ibn al-Arabi, the great Maliki scholar, and Imam Abu Abdullah al-Qurtubi, and Ibn al-Qayyim in his kitab al-Manar al-Munif, and Ibn Hajar al-Haytami in his kitab al-Fawtawa al-Hadithiyya, and Mulli al-Qari in his kitab Asrar al-Marfu'a fi Ahadith al-Mawdu'a, all of them did not accept these kind of stories. The reason why they rejected it is because Allah, the Prophet ﷺ mentioned, the Prophet told us وسلم, in the hadith Bukhari and Muslim both narrated, خَلَقَ اللَّهُ آدَمَ وَطُولُهُ فِي السَّمَاءِ سِتُونَ ذِرَاعًا. Allah created Adam, and how tall was he? Only 60 dhira is this long, 60 of this. The Prophet then said, فَلَمْ يَزَلِ الْخَلْقِ, the creation were consistently what? يَنْقُصُ حَتَّى الْآنِ, they were reducing until now. This hadith, I want to stand over it a bit. First of all, what does this hadith show us? What does this hadith show us? This hadith shows us that Adam alayhi salam was only 60 dira, and Adam was the tallest. So no one could be taller than Adam. And everybody was becoming less than Adam. So all of these khurafat and these things that don't have no reality, we don't accept it because it goes against the hadith in Bukhari and Muslim. Are we all together? The second thing that we take from this hadith is a misconception that some people have, which is that this ummah, as they go on, they become shorter and shorter, and that's not what the hadith mentioned. The hadith of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said in the hadith, فَلَمْ يَزَلِ الْخَلْقُ, the people will become short, and they were becoming short حَتَّى الْآنَ, until this time the Prophet was speaking, not after the Prophet. Are we all together, brothers? حَتَّى الْآنَ means until this moment. And so what is clear is, based on the explanation of the scholars, is that this ummah, they are generally the same in height. This ummah, from the time of the Prophet ﷺ until now, you still find people the same in height. Are we all together? The ummah not becoming shorter, as some may think. Allah says, أَلَمْ تَرَ كَيْفَ, do you not see? كَيْفَ فَعَلَ رَبُّكَ بِعَادٍ, the way Allah dealt with the people of Ad. Allah, how did He deal with the people of Ad? As I said, Allah sent with them a wind. إِنَّا أَرْسَلْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ رِيحًا صَرْصَرًا فِي يَوْمِ نَحْسٍ مُسْتَمِرٍ. Hey Ibrahim, what is it? Read the ayah next to it. إِنَّا أَرْسَلْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ رِيحًا صَرْصَرًا فِي يَوْمِ نَحْسٍ مُسْتَمِرٍ. Hey, hey آخري. تنزع الناس كأنهم أعجاز نخل منقعر. Allah destroyed them and they became like palm trees. What did they become? In another ayah, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He said, فَهَلْ تَرَى لَهُمْ مِنْ بَاقِيَةٍ. Do you see any remaining of theirs? Meaning, Allah never left the people of Ad, any one of them standing. All of them, Allah destroyed them. Are we all together, brothers? وَلِذَلِكَ, there's a group that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam spoke about that are going to come out. The Prophet spoke about a group called the Khawarij. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said that the Khawarij are going to come out. And he said to the Prophet said to the companions, يَحْقِرُ أَحَدُكُمْ صَلَاتَهُ مَعَ صَلَاتِهِمْ, one of you will belittle his prayer in comparison to their prayer. One of you would belittle the way he prays, you will belittle your prayer. وَصِيَامُهُ مَعَ صِيَامِهِمْ, and their fasting in accordance to their fasting. You belittle your fasting when you see their fasting, the way they fast and the way they pray and everything. The Prophet then said, يَمْرُقُونَ مِنَ الدِّينِ كَمَا يَمْرُقُ السَّهْمُ مِنَ الرَّمِيَّةِ, they exit the religion the way that the arrow exits the bow. The way the arrow, when it's thrown, it goes out the bow. They will exit the religion the same way. The Prophet said, لَإِنْ أَدَرَقْتُمْ, if I meet those people, لَأَقْتُلَنَّهُمْ قَتْلَ عَادٍ, I will kill them the way that Allah destroyed the people of Ad. Are we all together, brothers? At a time that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he took jizya from the non-Muslims and he gave them covenants. Are we all together, brothers? He took uhud and muathiq, covenants and treaties with the non-Muslims. And some of them he fought. But the Khawarij, he didn't say, I'm going to take a covenant with them. He said, I'm going to kill them all. Some of the scholars, they took from that, that he meant, I'm going to kill every single one of them if I see them. All of them. The Prophet ﷺ, he said, they are the evilest and the worst of the creation of Allah under the sky. Are we all together, brothers? The reason is because they make takfir of the Muslims and they call the Muslims kuffar easily and take them out of the fold of Islam, and then they permit the blood of the Muslims from there and they bring corruption and harm to the land. But the reason why I brought it here is because أَلَمْ تَرَ كَيْفَ فَعَلَ رَبُّكَ بِعَادٍ. The Prophet said, I'm going to destroy them like the people of Ad. And how did Allah destroy the people of Ad? فَهَلْ تَرَى لَهُمْ مِنْ بَاقِيَةٍ. None of them remained. None of them remained. Allah then says, إِرَمَ ذَاتِ الْعِمَادِ. The people of إِرَمَ. ذَاتُ الْعِمَادِ, they had what? Who had lofty pillars. They were strong and they were big and they were powerful. ذَاتِ الْعِمَادِ, we said, is الشِّدَّةُ وَالْقُوَّةِ. They were very strong. Allah then says, "Allati lam yukhlaq mithluha fil bilad." Their likes was not created. Allah did not create a nation, a people like that. The people of Ad, they were unique in their strength. They were unique in their power. ولذلك Allah says in another ayah, "Wadhkuru idh ja'alakum khulafa'a min ba'di qawmi Nuhin wa zadakum fil khalqi basta." Allah, He made them big. In another ayah, Allah says, وَإِذَا بَطَشْتُمْ بَطَشْتُمْ جَبَّارِينَ. They were, if they grabbed, they were like these palm trees that you can see today. Because what did the ayah mention? When they were destroyed, what did they become? Like empty palm trees that their fruits went off it. Imagine a destruction comes to a people and the only things that are on the floor is palm trees. Palm trees are very big, right? That's how tall they were. That's how tall they were. Brothers, if Allah destroyed a nation that strong and that powerful, would it be hard for Him to destroy people small and weak like us? It won't be. That's what you need to remember. Then Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, He says, وَثَمُودَ, and Allah also destroyed, Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, وَثَمُودَ الَّذِينَ جَابُوا الصَّخْرَ بِالْوَادِ. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ponder, think, contemplate over what? How Allah dealt with the people of Thamud. How did Allah deal with the people of Thamud? Allah said, كَذَّبَتْ ثَمُودُ بِالنُّذُرِ. They disbelieved. فَقَالُوا أَبَشَرًا مِنَّا وَاحِدًا نَتَّبِعُهُ إِنَّا إِذَا لَفِي الضَّلَالِ وَسُعُرٍ. أُلْقِيَ الذِّكْرُ عَلَيْهِ مِنْ بَيْنِنَا بَلْ هُوَ كَذَّابٌ أَشِرٌ. سَيَعْلَمُونَ غَدًا مَنِ الْكَذَّابِ الْأَشِرُ. إِنَّا مُرْسِلُ النَّاقَةِ فِتْنَةً لَهُمْ فَارْتَقِبْهُمْ وَاصْطَبِرْ وَنَبِّئْهُمْ أن الماء قسمة بينهم. هاي إبراهيم. Read loud. فنادوا. هاي. هاي. So what did Allah say about the people of Thamud? إنا أرسلنا عليهم صيحة واحدة فكانوا كهشيم المحتضر. What did Allah send on them? Allah sent on them صيحة, a sound. Noise, a loud noise Allah sent to them, subhanahu wa ta'ala. The people of Thamud, they were very strong. They were powerful. They used to live and they used to reside in on the corners of the caves. They used to go on the top and they used to carve it with their own hands. Allah said, وَكَانُوا يَنْحِتُونَ مِنَ الْجِبَالِ بُيُوتًا آمِنِينَ. وَكَانُوا يَنْحِتُونَ. They used to carve from the rocks, from their own hands. They ripped the rock, open it, and they would make their houses from there. وَكَانُوا يَنْحِتُونَ مِنَ الْجِبَالِ بُيُوتًا آمِنِينَ. Safe houses they would make from it. وَلِذَلِكَ, today if you go to Tabuk in Saudi Arabia, they're still there. If you go to the place of residency, it's still there. Because it's mountains that they carved into, it's still there. Just the doors and the windows and whatever they were using is not there. But you still can see the way they carved it. It's called Diyar Thamud, ama it's called Hijr Thamud, whatever it's called. لذلك سبحان الله, Allah destroyed them, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Today, if you go there, you don't even find insects there. Ants are not there. You don't see anything. So Allah sent punishment to them, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nothing and no one lives there. It's an empty place. This is how powerful they were. Allah says, وَثَمُودَ الَّذِينَ, and with Thamud, جَابُ الصَّخْرَ بِالْوَادِي, who carved out of the rocks in the valleys. If they wanted a place, they would move the mountains and make a road for themselves. That's the type of people they were. Very strong and powerful. Brothers, Allah destroyed the people like that. Allah got rid of them when they went against Allah's command and they did not follow what they were told to do. And when they came with the prohibitions. Then Allah mentioned, subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah mentioned, subhanahu wa ta'ala, Fir'aun. Three people have been mentioned now. What are the three groups? Ad. How did Allah destroy the people of Ad? Rihan sarsaran. Allah sent a wind on them, subhanahu wa ta'ala. The people of Thamud, how did Allah destroy them? Inna arsalna alayhim sayhatan wahidatan fakanu kahashimin muhtadar. The third one is Fir'aun and his army. How did Allah tabarak wa ta'ala destroy them? Allah drowned them. فَأَتْبَعَهُمْ فِرْعَوْنُ بِجُنُودِهِ فَغَشِيَهُمْ مِنَ الْيَمِّ مَا غَشِيَهُمْ. Fir'aun, he followed Nabi Musa into the ocean. What did Allah say to Nabi Musa? فَضْرِبْ بِعَصَاكَ الْبَحَرَ فَانْفَلَقَ فَكَانَ كُلُّ فِرْقٍ كَالطَّوْدِ الْعَظِيمِ. Are you with me, brothers? Nabi Musa was told, hit your stick on the ocean. And the ocean became two big mountains. And Nabi Musa went through. And then فَأَتْبَعَهُ Fir'aun, Fir'aun followed him, bijunudihi, with his army. Allah then says, فَغَشِيَهُمْ مِنَ الْيَمِّ مَا غَشِيَهُمْ. The ocean swallowed him. And Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he says, أَلْآنَ وَقَدْ عَصَيْتَ مِنْ قَبْلُ وَكُنْتَ مِنَ الْمُفْسِدِينَ فَالْيَوْمَ نُنَجِّيكَ بِبَدَنِكَ لِتَكُونَ لِمَنْ خَلْفَكَ آيَةً. Now you want to believe? Because when he saw that he was about to die, Fir'aun, and death was coming to him and he was drowning, Allah says, now you want to believe after you brought destruction to the earth, the time you brought harm and problems to the people. And you said, أَنَا رَبُّكُمُ الْأَعْلَى. You claim the Supreme Lord. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he says, فَالْيَوْمَ نُنَجِّيكَ بِبَدَنِكَ. Today we're going to save your body. لِتَكُونَ لِمَنْ خَلْفَكَ آيَةً. So those who come, like us, we can take a lesson from Fir'aun. And some of the Mufassirin, they mentioned the reason why Allah allowed Fir'aun's body to remain was because the people were scared of Fir'aun so much. فَاسْتَخَفَّ قَوْمَهُ فَأَطَاعُوهُ إِنَّهُمْ كَانُوا قَوْمًا فَاسِقِينَ. They obeyed Fir'aun because he oppressed them and he whipped them and he lashed them. So they didn't even believe that Fir'aun could die. So they wanted to see his body, to see that he really died. And so Allah showed him, there he is. The people were shocked. Are you with me, brothers? Allah destroyed him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if you look at the Quran, the reason why Allah destroyed these people is because they went against Allah's command. Allah says, فَأَمَّا عَادٌ فَاسْتَكْبَرُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ بِغَيْرِ الْحَقِّ وَقَالُوا مَنْ أَشَدُّ مِنَّا قُوَّةِ. The people of Ad, what did they do? فَأَمَّا عَادٌ فَاسْتَكْبَرُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ. They became arrogant on this earth and they thought, okay, we're the supreme power, we're the worst, we're the strongest people in the world. فَاسْتَكْبَرُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ بِغَيْرِ الْحَقِّ. And they had no rights to do that. And they said, وَقَالُوا مَنْ أَشَدُّ مِنَّا قُوَّةِ. Who is more stronger than us? Who has more power than us? Allah has more power than any individual. وَفِرْعَوْنَ. And Fir'aun, ذِلْ أَوْتَاد. What does it mean, ذِلْ أَوْتَاد? The word أَوْتَاد, the scholars, they differed in three views. The first view is that the word Otad, it means army. It comes from the word Watad, which is a peg. Some of the scholar books, it says stalks. But the reason why a peg is used is because why we can call the Otad as an army is because the government it stands on. You know the peg, you stand on it, right? The tent stands, it holds it down. The army, what does it do for the government? It holds the government. Without an army, the government will go. So some of the scholars, they said, وَفِرْعَوْن and Fir'aun, ذِلْ أَوْتَادِ, the one who had army. Fir'aun had an army. And that is the opinion of Ibn Abbas. And some scholars, they said, Dhul Awtad, it means Al-Hibal, the ropes. It actually means the ropes. And these ropes are the ropes that Fir'aun used to use to punish the people. When he said, فَلَأُقَطِّعَنَّ أَيْدِيَكُمْ وَأَرْجُلَكُمْ مِنْ خِلَافٍ وَلَأُصَلِّبَنَّكُمْ فِي جُذُوعِ النَّخْلِ وَلَتَعْلَمُنَّ أَيُّنَا أَشَدُّ عَذَابًا وَأَبْقَى. When he cut the people, he said, I'm going to cut your hands, right hand and your left leg, and I'm going to hang you onto the trees, and you're going to know whose punishment is more severe, my punishment or Allah Azza wa Jal. The ropes that he was using. And the third view is, the scholars, they said, the places where Fir'aun would play, he would shade himself and he would make himself a tent where he would go out and play and enjoy himself. And Ibn Jarir al-Tabari, he pushed the two last opinions. The first and the third opinion, he pushed, rahimahullah. وَفِرْعَوْنَ أَنْ فِرْعَوْنَ ذِي الْأَوْتَادِ. And do you not look at Muhammad, how Allah destroyed Fir'aun and his army and everything that he had. Allah destroyed it, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah mentions all three of them. He says, الَّذِينَ, the ones. الَّذِينَ goes back to brothers who? Ad, Thamud, and Fir'aun. الَّذِينَ, the ones. طَغَوْ. What does طَغَوْ mean? They exceeded their limits. The word الطُغْيَان, what does it mean? الطُغْيَان means exceeding your boundaries and your limits. الَّذِينَ, the ones. طَغَوْ, they exceeded their boundaries. They oppressed فِي الْبِلَادِ, on the land. How do they do oppression on the land? Brothers, committing sins is an oppression on this earth. When you sin, it's an oppression on this earth. And also, Fir'aun, what did he do? He oppressed. He oppressed the people. And he wronged the people because he thought he was the ultimate power. فَأَكْثَرُوا فِيهَا الْفَسَادِ. And Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he said, and increased on this earth corruption. فَصَبَّ عَلَيْهِمْ. Your Lord Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he poured upon them. فَصَبَّ عَلَيْهِمْ. Allah poured upon them. سَوْطَ عَذَابٍ. What does this word salt mean in the Arabic language? The word salt means a lash. And the reason why Allah used that word salt is that when a person is being punished, generally use a whip to lash the individual. And that's what the Sahabas understood in Mecca, because that's what was done to them. They were lashed when they took Islam. But here it means how each party Allah destroyed them. The people of Ad, Allah, how did he send adab on them? We mentioned it, by sending a wind to them. Are we all together? And the people of Thamud, where did Allah destroy them? A sound Allah sent to them, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Fir'aun, how did Allah destroy him? By drowning him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَصَبَّ عَلَيْهِمْ. Allah poured onto them سَوْطَ عَذَاب, a scourge of punishment Allah placed on them, subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنَّ رَبَّكَ, your Lord, brothers and sisters, لَبِالْمِرْصَاد, your Lord Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is observing, is looking at us. The word mirsad, it means يَرْقُبُ أَعْمَال. Allah is observing. You see, brothers, there's a difference between looking and seeing and observing. Observing is looking at detailed. It's a detailed observation. It's a detailed look. That's what observation is. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is observing us. This ayah by itself can move a mountain, wallahi. Inna rabbaka, your Lord, labil mirsad. He is looking at your actions. And Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he sees everything which you say and everything which you do. Inna rabbaka, your Lord, labil mirsad. I'm going to conclude, inshaAllah ta'ala, with how the sins, brothers, when it occurs from you, it takes away the blessings. Brothers, al-ma'asi sababun lizawalin ni'am. Memorize that. The sins are the reasons why blessings go. The good and the blessings that you had will go. It won't remain for you anymore. Let's mention some of the evidence. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said to the companions, وَمَا أَصَابَكُم مِّن مُصِيبَةٍ, the things that you were afflicted with and the harm that touched you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, وَمَا أَصَابَكُم, it didn't afflict you, these harm and these pain and these problems did not afflict you, except through what reason? إِلَّا بِمَا كَسَبَتْ أَيْدِيكُمْ مِن مُصِيبَةٍ فَبِمَا كَسَبَتْ أَيْدِيكُمْ وَيَعْفُ عَنْ كَثِيرٍ. It only came to you because of that which your hands put forward. Pay attention. Allah is clearly telling us, وَمَا أَصَابَكُمْ مِن مُصِيبَةٍ فَبِمَا كَسَبَتْ أَيْدِيكُمْ. And look what Allah said after that, وَيَعْفُ عَنْ كَثِيرٍ. And He actually forgave us for a lot. Because of everything we did, He took away the blessings from us, we wouldn't even live. He only is punishing us for some of the sins that we did. Are we all together, brothers? Sins will take away blessings from you. Because brothers, if Allah sends a punishment on us, there's one of two ways that we can answer this. We can either say Allah is oppressing us, subhanahu wa ta'ala, and this is His oppression. Subhanallah, ma'adallah, can we say that about Allah? And the second one is that we blame ourselves. And we say, this is what we've done to ourselves. Allah says in another ayah, فَأَكْثَرُوا فِيهَا الْفَسَادِ فَصَبَّ عَلَيْهِمْ رَبُّكَ سَوْطَ عَذَابٍ. فَأَكْثَرُوا فِيهَا الْفَسَادِ, they increased in the corruption that they brought to this earth. And then look what Allah says, فَصَبَّ عَلَيْهِمْ رَبُّكَ سَوْطَ عَذَابٍ. And then Allah sent to them a severe punishment. The punishment, when did it come? فَأَكْثَرُوا فِيهَا الْفَسَادِ, when they increased in the corruption that they were causing, then the punishment came. Allah says in another ayah, وَلَوْ أَنَّ أَهْلَ الْقُرَىٰ آمَنُوا, if the people of the village were to believe, وَاتَّقَوْا, and they were to come with taqwa, لَفَتَحْنَا, we would have opened for them, عَلَيْهِمْ بَرَكَاتٍ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ, we would have opened for them the blessings of the sky, وَالْأَرْضِ, the blessing from the sky is that we would have sent rain, and we would have sent وَالْأَرْضِ, from this earth, we would have brought crops from them, from the earth. وَلَكِنْ, but we're not going to do neither of those for them. Why? وَلَكِنْ كَذَّبُوا, they disbelieved. فَأَخَذْنَاهُمْ, Allah says, we grabbed them, subhanahu wa ta'ala, بِمَا كَانُوا يَكْسِبُونَ, because of that which they did. Look what we said. وَلَوْ أَنَّ أَهْلَ الْقُرَىٰ آمَنُوا وَاتَّقَوْا لَفَتَحْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ بَرَكَاتٍ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَلَكِنْ كَذَّبُوا فَأَخَذْنَاهُمْ بِمَا كَانُوا يَكْسِبُونَ. It's simple. All that was needed from was iman and taqwa. What did Allah then say? I would have sent on them from the sky barakat, blessings. Why does Allah say, I'll send from the sky barakat? Because some of the rains, brothers, it can destroy. Some of the rain, it can destroy. What destroyed the people of Nuh? Was it not rain that was sent down? Are we all together, brothers? The people of Ad, even what destroyed them? فَلَمَّا رَأُوهُ عَارِضًا مُسْتَقْبِلَ أَوْدِيَتِهِمْ قَالُوا هَذَا عَارِضٌ مُمْطِرُنَا بَلْ هُوَ مَسْتَعْجَلْتُمْ بِهِ رِيحٌ فِيهَا عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ تُدَمِّرُ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ بِأَمْرِ رَبِّهَا فَأَصْبَحُوا لَا يُرَى إِلَّا مَسَاكِنُهُمْ. Pay attention. The rain that comes down can sometimes be a punishment from Allah. وَلِذَلِكَ the messenger, whenever it rained or the sky became dark, دَخَلَ وَخَرَجْ, he would enter the room and he would come out and he would enter and you could be seen on his face. And then the Sahaba, they said, Ya Rasulullah, it's a rain, it's bringing blessings for us. And then the Prophet said, فَلَمَّا رَأُوهُ عَارِضًا مُسْتَقْبِلَ أَوْدِيَتِهِمْ قَالُوا هَذَا عَارِضٌ مُنْطِرُنَا. That's what the people of Ad said. When they saw this cloud coming together and it becoming dark, the people of Ad, they didn't know it was the day that they were being punished. They said, it's going to be a nice rain. But it was actually the day that the wind was coming. It was how it was formatting and how things were happening, brothers. Allah also said in another ayah, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, those of you who believe, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ تَوَلَّوْا مِنْكُمْ يَوْمَ الْتَقَى الْجَمْعَانِ, those of you who turned away when the two armies met one another. This is the battle of Uhud. Those of you who turned away, because that day some of the companions, they ran away from the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. Are you with me, brothers? And our messenger was one of the bravest people when it came to battle. Nabiullahi Muhammad never turned his back in the battlefield, sallallahu alayhi wasallam. He never turned his back. Rather, when the Sahabas, they ran away from him, in the middle of the battle, he stood up, he said, I am the Prophet of Allah. أَنَا النَّبِيُّ لَا كَذِبْ أَنَا ابْنُ عَبْدِ الْمُطَّلِبِ. Imagine, in the middle of the battlefield, the overwhelming majority of your soldiers and your army ran away from you. The enemy is willing to kill you, and you shout your name out and you tell them, I'm the Prophet of Allah. The only one who could do that is a brave and a courageous individual. Sah? He was very brave, salawatullahi wa salam alayhi. So he's calling his companions to come back, but he's saying his name out. He's saying who he is. He's not scared, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So Allah says, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ تَوَلَّوْا مِنْكُمْ يَوْمَ الْتَقَى الْجَمْعَانِ. Those of you who turned their backs when the two armies met one another, إِنَّمَا اسْتَزَلَّهُمُ الشَّيْطَانُ. Shaytan made them slip. إِنَّمَا اسْتَزَلَّهُمُ الشَّيْطَانُ. Shaytan made them slip. Why? بِبَعْضِمَا كَسَبُوا. Because of some of the sins and the mistakes that they came with. The reason why Shaytan succeeded in getting to them is because of the mistakes that they did. In another ayah, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala tells us a story, brothers. Allah tells us a story. He says, وَضَرَبَ اللَّهُ مَثَلًا قَرْيَةً كَانَتْ آمِنَةً مُطْمَئِنَّةً يَأْتِيهَا رِزْقُهَا رَغَدًا مِنْ كُلِّ مَكَانٍ فَكَفَرَتْ بِأَنْعُمِ اللَّهِ فَأَذَاقَهَا اللَّهُ لِبَأْسَ الْجُوعِ وَالْخَوْفِ بِمَا كَانُوا يَصْنَعُونَ. Allah tells us about Mecca. Mecca, the rizq was coming to them from where? يَأْتِيهَا رِزْقُهَا رَغَدًا مِنْ كُلِّ مَكَانٍ. The blessing and the rizq was coming to them from every direction. Allah then says, فَكَفَرَتْ. What does فَكَفَرَتْ here mean? It means they did not show what? Shukur. The kufr here means kufr ni'mah. They disbelieved in the blessing. They did not show gratitude, and because the blessing once sent their way, they should have responded to it with what? Gratitude. They didn't do that. They used the body that were given to them, the fingers and the eyes and the mouth and the ears that were given to them. They used it for that which was haram. And so then, is that blessing going to remain? Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, look what he said, فَأَذَاقَهَا اللَّهُ لِبَأْسَ الْجُوعِ وَالْخَوْفِ بِمَا كَانُوا يَصْنَعُونَ. Because of what they did, Allah made the people of Mecca, hunger and poverty and fear came to them. When Allah blesses us, brothers, we should not introduce haram. We should not introduce sins in our lives, because that blessing, the safety that we have, the blessings that we have, the good that we have, Allah will go. Allah says, فَبِمَا نَقْضِهِمْ مِيثَاقَهُمْ لَعَنَّاهُمْ وَجَعَلْنَا قُلُوبَهُمْ قَاسِيَةً. In another ayah, Allah says, إِنَّا بَلَوْنَاهُمْ كَمَا بَلَوْنَا أَصْحَابَ الْجَنَّةِ إِذَا أَقْسَمُوا لَيَسْلِمُنَّهَا مُسْبِحِينَ. You all know the story of the boy, the boys who their father left behind a garden for them in Suratul Qalam. Allah left for them what? A garden. And Allah, their father was a righteous man. What he used to do was, the garden, when it reached the time to give the zakat from it, he used to follow the ayah, وَآتُوا حَقَّهُ يَوْمَ حَصَادِ. He would give the zakat from it. But then, and he would tell the poor people to come into the garden, and he would say, choose what you want, whatever crops you want, take. And they would do it. But when he died, his children took over, they changed their situation. And they went against the way that their father was. And so what did they do? They told, أَلَّا يَدْخُلَنَّهَا الْيَوْمَ عَلَيْكُمْ مِسْكِينَ. No miskin is going to enter this garden today. We're not going to let none of them enter. Our father was confused. He didn't know what he was doing. We have to look after our property. So we're not going to let no miskin enter. What happened to them? فَطَافَ عَلَيْهَا طَائِفٌ مِّن رَبِّكَ وَهُمْ نَائِمُونَ فَأَصْبَحَتْ كَالسَّرِيمِ فَتَنَادَوْا مُصْبِحِينَ. When they woke up in the morning, they thought they planned everything out. In the morning, they were planning to not enter, to not let the poor enter. But little did they know, Allah also planned, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah planned, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah made the whole entire garden, Allah made it sareem, it made into ashes. If you look at the Salaf brothers, whenever they entered onto their wives and their families, if they saw their wife was not obeying them, and if they saw that their family members and everyone was against them, even if their riding beast was not doing as they used to say, إِذَا عَصَيْنَا اللَّهَ. If we disobey Allah, كُنَّا نَرَى أَثَرَ ذَلِكَ. We used to see the effects of our sins and our wives and our children and on our riding beast. Everything doesn't work. But where did they believe that this problem came to them from? That the wife wasn't listening and the children were not listening and the whole family, where did they think it came to them from? Their own sins. Because they believed it came from them. And that's why they are in the situation that they're in. Allah also tells us about the story of لَقَدْ كَانَ لِسَبَئٍ فِي مَسْكَنِهِمْ آيَةٌ جَنَّتَانِ عَنْ يَمِينِ وَشِمَالِ كُلُوا مِنْ رِزْقِ رَبِّكُمْ وَاشْكُرُوا لَهُ بَلْدَةٌ طَيِّبَةٌ وَرَبٌّ غَفُورٌ فَأَعْرَضُوا فَأَرْسَلْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ سَيْلَ الْعَرِمِ وَبَدَّلْنَاهُمْ بِجَنَّتَيْهِمْ جَنَّتَيْنِ ذَوَاتَيْ أُكُلٍ خَمْطٍ وَأَثْلٍ وَشَيْءٍ مِنْ سِدْرٍ قَلِيلٍ ذَلِكَ جَزَيْنَاهُمْ بِمَا كَفَرُوا وَهَلْ نُجَازِي إِلَّا الْكَفُورَ. Allah mentions many stories like that. إن قارون كان من قوم موسى فبغى عليهم وآتيناه من الكنوز ما إن مفاتيحه لتنوء بالعصبة أولي القوة. Qarun had money, had everything. But did he obey Allah? Did he go against Allah's command? Allah said, فَخَسَفْنَا بِهِ وَبِدَارِهِ الْأَرْضِ فَمَا كَانَ لَهُ مِنْ فِيَأْتِ يَنْصُرُونَهُ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ وَمَا كَانَ مِنَ الْمُتَصِرِ. He had no one to help him. He had no one to aid him. Nobody to support him. Allah, he made the earth swallow him, Qarun. Are we all together, brothers? There is a way that Allah deals with criminals and sinners. And that is, whatever blessing was given to them will be taken away from them when they disobey Allah, when they go against Allah's command. Inna rabbaka labil mirsad. Indeed, your Lord is observing your actions and everything that you do. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. And wallahi, brothers, nothing is hidden from Him. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ya'lamu kha'inat al-a'yuni wa ma tukhfi as-sudur. Allah knows that the person who's trying to deceive the people, and Allah knows what's in the people's chests. He knows what's in the people's hearts. I ask Allah Azza wa Jalla to make us those who are righteous privately and publicly. And may Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala forgive us for any shortcomings or mistakes that we may have come from with. Innahu waliyu dhalika wal qadiru alayh. Subhanaka Allahumma bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayh.